Good evening, everyone. I would like to start with the quote of Sister Faustina. My daughter, encourage souls to say the chaplet which I have given to you. It pleases me to grant everything they ask of me by saying the chaplet. When hardened sinners say it, I will fill their souls with peace, and at the hour of their death will be a happy one. Today, I'm going to explain to you how to recite the chaplet of Divine Mercy. Divine Mercy chaplet is said every day at 3:30 p.m. We start the chaplet by making the sign of the cross, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Then we start with the prayer to obtain graces through the intercession of Saint Faustina. O Jesus, who filled Saint Faustina with profound veneration for your boundless mercy, deign, if it be your holy will, to grant me, through intercession, the grace for which I fervently pray. My sins render me unworthy of your mercy, but be mindful of Saint Faustina's spirit of sacrifice and self-denial, and reward our virtues by granting the petitions which, with childlike trust, I present to you through intercession. Now we will do an Our Father, one Hail Mary, and then the Glory Be. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Then we ask for Sister Faustina's intercession throughout this chaplet by saying, Saint Faustina, pray for us. We continue with the opening prayer. You expired, Jesus, but the source of life gushed forth for souls, and the ocean of mercy opened up for the whole world. O fount of life, unfathomable divine mercy, envelop the whole world and empty yourself out upon us. O blood and water, which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as a fount of mercy for us, I trust in you. After the opening prayer, we will do one Our Father, one Hail Mary, and then the Apostles' Creed. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate. He was crucified, died, and he was buried. He descended to death. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Then we will start with the large bead by saying the prayer, Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, the soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world. And then in these small 10 beads, we say the prayer, for the sake of Jesus' sorrowful passion, Abba Father, have mercy on us and on the whole world. We will repeat it like this till the end. Then we come back to the large bead again by saying the prayer 3 times. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Then we conclude with the closing prayer. Eternal God, in whom mercy is endless and the treasury of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we might not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy itself. Amen. Followed by the healing prayer. Jesus, you are my wounded healer. Heal me by your wounds. Forgive my sins and those of my forefathers. Through your bloodshed, and fill me with your Holy Spirit by the power of your resurrection. Amen. Then the consecration prayer. Lord, I consecrate my family members, myself and my dear ones, into your Eucharistic heart and immaculate heart of Mother Mary for great transformation and miracles. Amen. Then the last prayer. Prayer for the grace to be merciful to others. O most Holy Trinity, as many times as I breathe, as many times as my heart beats, as many times as my blood pulsates through my body, so many thousand times do I want to glorify your mercy. I want to be completely transformed into your mercy and to be your living reflection. O Lord, may the greatest of all divine attributes, that of your unfathomable mercy, pass through my heart and soul to my neighbor. Help me, O Lord, that my eyes may be merciful, so that I may never suspect or judge from appearances, but look for what is beautiful in my neighbor's souls and come to their rescue. Help me that my ears may be merciful, so that I may give heed to my neighbor's needs and not to be indifferent to their pains and mournings. Help me, O Lord, that my tongue may be merciful, so that I should never speak negatively of my neighbor, but have a word of comfort and forgiveness for all. Help me, O Lord, that my hands may be merciful and filled with good deeds, so that I may do only good to my neighbor and take upon myself the more difficult and toilsome task. Help me that my feet may be merciful, so that I may hurry to assist my neighbor, overcoming my own fatigue and weariness. My true rest is in the service of my neighbor. Help me, O Lord, that my heart may be merciful, so that I myself may feel all the sufferings of my neighbor. I will refuse my heart to no one. I will be sincere even with those who I know will abuse my kindness. And I will lock myself up in the most merciful heart of Jesus. I will bear my own sufferings in silence. May your mercy, O Lord, rest upon me. Amen. Then we conclude with the Glory be to the Father. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord.